But then they get the win back against Hawaii, and obviously looking forward to a big game on the road against San Jose State this week.
And joining us right now, the quarterback's coach for the Red and Black out of the Air Force Academy, Blaine Morgan, with us here on Exa 1360 Fox Sports San Diego. Blaine, how you doing?
I'm doing great. Just walked off the practice field.
Before we talk about the quarterback's job and your coaching at San Diego State, going back to your Air Force days, did you experience big games against San Diego State when you played them?
No, we had a couple games. We had my last year I was at Air Force, the Aztecs, that was 3 years ago, the Aztecs had to win to get bowl eligible. And so they were amped up, and we kind of had a long run. A little bit like this year, where we played a bunch of physical games in a row, and the Aztecs got after us a little bit. So that was memorable for me because we couldn't do anything on offense.
That's strange, Blaine, because obviously Air Force always seems to do everything offensively. Of course, your brother Bo and Blaine, and the late great Dee Dowse. When I think back to Air Force football, going back all the way to the Fisher Berry days. It was always a challenge, wasn't it? I mean, for the other team to try to get ready, and this is true of all the military schools, when you're playing an offense that, so few. I mean, I've always wondered if you could transfer that offense to an Alabama or a Ohio State, would it work as well as it's done for the military schools over the years, Blaine?
I think if you've got good players, any offense you run is going to be successful.
Yeah.
Especially if you're pitching a wide toss to Rashad Penny or Juwan Washington, and they're pitching at the guys that are, 4-6 guys. Taking an option pitch and getting that thing on the perimeter with guys that can take it the distance, man, it would be lethal.
Well, and I think back,
your fan base might not be happy.
Right. I was going to say, I think back to the 70s. I'm old enough to remember the 70s when suddenly the Alabamas, the Oklahomas, UCLAs are all unleashing in Texas the wishbone, with supreme athletes running that wishbone offense. And it's like, forget it. You couldn't stop. They run for 500-600 yards a game, Blaine. It was ridiculous.
Right, you've got home run hitters at every position. And you remember the Oklahomas and the Colorados when they won the national championship, the Darian Hagans. I mean, they had home run hitters at every position.
Yeah.
So,
Blaine, how did you end up at San Diego State? You were coaching at the academy. How did you become an Aztec assistant coach?
It was an interesting process. Jeff Horton and I, our offensive coordinator, kind of go way back. We're from the same area. And while I was at Air Force, I recruited Dallas Fort Worth. And we would run in, it's kind of a small family, the guys that recruit certain areas. You get to know each other. You run into each other at schools. And so, I'd run into them and kind of got to know them a little bit. And then as a player, played against them when he was the head coach at UNLV. So had a relationship with him. And, coming out here to San Diego and playing the Aztecs, I thought, man, if they could get some consistent quarterback play, they could – I really thought San Diego State could be a powerhouse and win conference championships, and I really thought that could be the case. And that's what I wanted to do. I wanted to go to a school, if I made a move, that where we could win consistently some championships.
Well, let's talk about Blaine Morgan joining us right now, San Diego State Aztecs quarterback coach. Let's talk about Christian Chapman, because you've been there throughout his development at San Diego State. Let's go back to your first encounter with Christian and where he is right now. Take us through the process of where Chapman has started and where he is right now.
Absolutely. The first encounter I had with him was when I was thinking about taking the job here, I went back and watched every high school film of everyone they had on campus. I wanted to see if they had any quarterbacks that could play. And really, his was the one that kind of stood out. I thought, hey, this kid's kind of ran a very similar offense in high school. I thought, quick release. I thought he was the one kid that stood out a little bit. And then when I showed up on campus, there were six total quarterbacks. And so got my hands on him and really liked just his decision making, what he did, and then didn't end up winning the job as redshirt freshman year because we had Max Smith, from Kentucky, and then really got thrust into the job in the Nevada game, the game before the Mountain West Conference Championship game. And his first start, if you remember, was the Mountain West Conference Championship
right.
game, and he played pretty darn well. It was very decisive, but still he was young, and so he, really had to work in the off season developing his body. Came back last year and had a good season, but I thought there were some things that just consistency. I was looking for some consistency. He was looking for some development in arm strength, and early in the season this year, kind of saw signs of those things. I thought we had to throw the deep ball a little bit better, and we've shown signs of him. But a lot of the things that the public sees, they don't really see every day in practice habits, leadership, and that sort of thing. And that's where he's come the furthest. I mean, he really has. You look back at last year and how he played last year, and compared to this year, obviously, you've got four different guys up front, which in protection certainly creates some challenges. Those guys are coming along and creates a little more confidence and in the passing game.
Blaine, he's got Christian Chapman's got the physical tools. We've seen it now the last couple of years or so. But are you guys at the point now, you and Jeff, with Christian, where he is starting to see through his eyes what you guys are seeing through your eyes?
Yes. He showed, I would say, in the first 7-8 games, he really showed tremendous progress as far as just decision-making and seeing a defense. And there were very, very few errors as far as him knowing where to go with the ball. Now, as the season goes on and you get beat up and you try not to let that physical, beating you're taking as a quarterback, affect you mentally. And so that's where I'd like to, just see him close out as we close out the season, his last few games, just see him get back to, just being on par and completely decisive, knowing where to go with the ball and just dialed in, because he's an accurate guy. When he knows where to go with the ball, he's as accurate as anybody in the country. And so that's what I'm looking forward to, is just challenge them this week to, let's get back on track throwing the ball and, see if we can pitch and catch a little bit.
Blaine, this team started 6-0, and we were getting ready for the Boise game and really encouraging fans to show up, and they did. 49,000 is a phenomenal crowd out of the stadium. Rocky kept saying, week after week, I know we're undefeated, but we haven't played that great. I mean, we found ways to win. The effort has been off the charts, but we're doing things that we really shouldn't be doing. And then you get these back-to-back games against Boise and Fresno, and you're like, what happened here? What was happening with the coaches? What was happening, with the players during that? And obviously a nice rebound win against Hawaii, but was it even amplified more because of the fact you guys got off to maybe an unexpected 6-0 start?
I think so. I think as coaches, you look at those games and you look at the opponents and you look how the ball bounced a little bit, and your ball bounced our way. We had a lot of guys make plays at very, very poignant time, and then you get a couple games where, you have a play here or there where those plays aren't made, and now the game looks completely different. And when as a coach, you understand what the reality is, and you're trying to each week just trying to find a way to find a way to win. So that's what we were able to do in those first six games. The last two, we didn't make the same plays that we had. And, it goes back to the simple things like, turnover margin, where you turn the ball over and you give up a touchdown at quarterback, and you know, and you lose the turnover battle and the game starts to swing a little bit. So it can be as simple as that. But you try, and as a coach, you lose the game and you analyze everything. So.
Aztecs quarterbacks coach Blaine Morgan with us here on Extra 1360 Fox Sports San Diego. Blaine, as an offense, have you guys, and this not necessarily is a bad thing, have you put together a complete game yet?
That's a great question. As I haven't had a whole lot of time to really look back game by game, even though you do go back and kind of midway through the season, you take an inventory of what you've done well and what you and you try to make that your offense as far as the passing game goes. I absolutely don't think we've played our best and most complete game. I think that game's still out there.
And I think that's a positive.
Absolutely. I think you've had up front in the O-line, you've had so many musical chairs going around that finally you get a group the last 2 weeks that guys have been in the same spot, and you kind of saw what happened last week.
Yeah.
You know, guys are knowing what to do coming off the ball. Now they're starting to work together, and you know, you got three. I mean, you still have three freshmen and, you know, one true freshman at center. That's, man, that's a tough for any team, you know. So he's done an awesome job. He's a San Diego kid, and man, what an awesome kid.
Well, I'll tell you what, Blaine. Obviously, it was good to get back on the winning track. Big game this week on the road against San Jose State, and. You know what? That Mountain West Conference championship game is back in the books now that Fresno just lost a game. Maybe they can lose a couple more games and the Aztecs can get back to that Mountain West Conference championship game for a third consecutive year. Coach, we always appreciate the time. Thank you so much.
Appreciate it. Thanks, guys.
Thank you.
All right, there he is, Blaine Morgan. Interesting background. I mean, when you think of the makeup of this coaching staff for Rocky Long, to bring in a guy who, you know, not only played at Air Force, but was there for so many years, part of their coaching staff. It seems like an interesting hire.